From farm to market. Long ago, most people in the United States lived and worked on small farms. Back then, farm families got all the food they needed from the crops and livestock they raised right there on their own farms. Livestock is another word for farm animals. They not only ate their own vegetables, fruits, and meats, they also made their own bread, butter, and cheese using products from the farm. Here on my farm, we still make a lot of things that most people buy at the supermarket or other stores. For instance, instead of eating everything as soon as we harvest it, we pack some of our produce in glass jars. This is called canning. We make our own canned beets, beans, and pears. Unlike fresh fruits and vegetables, even if you keep them in a refrigerator, canned food will not spoil. It will not rot or go bad as quickly. It will remain edible for months and even years. Long, long ago, farm families made their own butter in a butter churn. We still have a butter churn on our farm, but it's just for decoration. We don't use it anymore, but back then, someone would pour some milk into the churn and swish it up and down and all around with a stick. It took a while and it was hard work, but eventually the milk got churned and whipped so much that it thickened and turned into butter. Sometimes, just for fun, we still make our own ice cream using a machine like a butter churn. We use fresh milk from the cows and churn it in a special ice cream machine. It takes a while to make, but it sure tastes good. But most farmers, including me, do not grow or make everything they need for their families on their own farms. I do not grow coconuts, mangoes, or pineapples, but I like to eat them. Nor do I raise turkeys, but I eat one every Thanksgiving. So, where do I get all these things that I use but do not grow or make on the farm? I buy them, just like everyone else. I take my extra produce to sell at the farmer's market once or twice a week. That's where I earn some of my money. Earn means to get something by working for it. Today, I will take beans, tomatoes, corn, and eggs. Come along, let's see how business is at the market today. Goodness, there are a lot of people here today. I just backed my pickup truck under the tent and opened up the tailgate, and before I knew it, I had a line of people waiting to buy my fresh produce. After I've sold all my goods, I think I will wander around and see what the other farmers have to offer. There's Barry, the beekeeper, over there. He has jars of dark, rich honey made by his very own bees. I bet he will trade me a big jar of honey for 2 or 3 dozen eggs. Yum! I see Mary the flower lady, too. She brought zinnias, daisies, and sunflowers from her flower farm. I'll buy a bouquet for Mrs. MacDonald before I go to the supermarket for some other things I need. Look at all the food in this supermarket. There are so many choices I can't even begin to count all the different types of breakfast cereals or canned fruits and vegetables. They also sell beef, chicken, pork, milk, eggs, juice, yogurt, noodles, cheese, crackers, and many other things. Whenever I go grocery shopping, I can't help but think about the fact that nearly everything here got its start on a farm. All grocery stores have a canned food aisle. These cans come from canning factories, where farm produce is packed into metal cans or glass jars and labeled so you can tell what it is inside. This man is loading boxes of corn onto a truck. A few months ago, the corn in those boxes was growing on a plant somewhere in a farmer's field. Now it's in a box on its way to a grocery store. There is really no telling where it will end up now. For all you know, it could wind up in your belly. Here is another place where farm produce is processed. Processed means prepared. Have you ever seen so many apples? I work hard just to grow a few dozen apples to take to market. I can't imagine trying to grow so many of them, but some farmers do. These apples were harvested a few days ago, But the farmer had to wait for a truck driver to come and pick them up and drive them to the processing plant to be washed, sorted, processed, packaged, and then trucked off to the grocery store. Some of these apples will probably be sold at the grocery store in the produce section so that you can munch on one. Can you think of other ways that apples are prepared and eaten? Here are just a few foods made from apples. How many have you tasted and eaten? Did you get them at the farm or at the market?